A very good morning to all of you. Here I am with the fifth video from the same unit, motion. In the last video I have discussed the distance time graph, and here I am going to start the velocity time graph. Velocity time graph shows how the velocity of a body changes with time. To draw velocity time graph, velocity of the body is plotted along the y-axis and the time taken by the body is plotted along the x-axis. And the first case I am going to take as velocity time graph for a body moving with constant velocity. That is, when a body moves with a constant velocity and its velocity does not change with time. Observe in figure 23 here. If the velocity of a body at t is equal to 0 is 5 meter per second, then the velocity of the body will remain 5 meter per second for all times. Velocity time graph for such type of motion of the body is represented by a straight line AB parallel to time axis, as it is shown here. So what we conclude from here? So conclusion is, velocity time graph of a body moving with constant velocity is a straight line parallel to time axis. Now let us discuss use of velocity time graph for a body moving with constant velocity. And here we have, it can be used for the calculation of magnitude of displacement. So again observe figure 23. Here in this figure, draw perpendicular from the point corresponding to the time t1 and t2 on the graph. Let these perpendiculars are dp and cb respectively. So here just see what we have. Dp is equal to cb, which is equal to velocity of the body, and it is 5 meter per second. CD is equal to what? T2 minus T1. That is the time interval. And we have 5 minus 2 equal to 3 seconds. So now, the area of rectangle PBCD. This can be written as DP into CD. And so we have DP into CD is equal to velocity into time. Because here dp is giving us velocity and cd gives us time. Therefore we have magnitude of the displacement, and the magnitude of the displacement of the body is equal to area under velocity time graph. At this point of time, we must keep in our mind that speed time graph for a body moving with constant speed is same as shown alongside in the figure 23. The only difference is that the speed is written instead of velocity along y-axis. Moving ahead, I will discuss velocity time graph for an object moving with uniform acceleration when initially the body is at rest. That is, initially the body, that is at t is equal to 0, the body is having u is equal to 0. So observe figure 25 here. Here in this figure, in every unit time interval of time, the velocity of the body increases by an equal amount. Velocity time graph for such type of motion of a body is represented as it is represented here by a line OA. So what we conclude? Velocity time graph of a body having uniform motion initially at rest is a straight line passing through the origin and has a constant slope. Now I will discuss uses of velocity time graph for an object moving with uniform acceleration. So please again see figure 25, and it will be better for you that you make this figure in your note copy. And the very first is calculation of acceleration. As we know, acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken. So here from the figure we have change in velocity that is given by AB, V2 minus V1, and time taken is OB, that is T2 minus T1. So we have 12 minus 0 divided by 6 minus 0, and finally acceleration is equal to 2 meter per second square. Next, calculation of magnitude of displacement. Magnitude of displacement we can get by calculating the area under velocity time graph. So here we have area under OA, which is area of the triangle OAB. And as we know, the area of triangle is equal to half into base into height. So we can write half OB into AB. And what is OB? T2 minus T1. And what is AB? V2 minus V1. So we have half T2 minus T1 into V2 minus V1. So finally we have half into 6 into 12, and this gives us 36 meter. So the magnitude of displacement in this case is 36 meter. Moving ahead, velocity time graph for an object moving with uniform acceleration when initially body is not at rest. That is, for t is equal to 0, the body must be having some velocity. For this, let us consider figure 26. In this figure, at t is equal to 0, the velocity of a body is 2 meter per second. After that, the velocity of the body increases at a constant rate. That is, in every unit interval of time, the velocity of the body increases by an equal amount. And here in this figure, velocity time graph for such type of motion of the body is represented by a line AB as shown it is here. Moving ahead, I will consider velocity time graph when the velocity of the body decreases uniformly to 0. And for this, observe figure 27 here. In this figure, let the velocity of a train at t is equal to 0 is 10 meter per second. The driver of the train applies the brake so that the velocity of the train decreases uniformly to 0. So in this velocity time graph, the line AB represents its motion. Let me discuss the uses of velocity time graph here. In first, it can be used for calculating the acceleration. In this situation, how can we use this? As we know, acceleration is equal to slope of velocity time graph. So in this figure, we have slope of AB line, and we can get it by OA divided by OB. That is V2 minus V1 by T2 minus T1. And here we have V2 minus V1 is equal to minus 10 meter per second. T2 minus T1 is equal to 5 second. So after calculation, we will have minus 2 meter per second square. Observe it carefully. Negative sign shows that the acceleration of the train is negative. And the next use of it is, we can also calculate using velocity time graph the displacement of the body. And displacement is equal to, here in this case, area of triangle OAB. And as we know, area of triangle is equal to what? Half into base into height. So it is 1 by 2, base is T2 minus T1 and height is V2 minus V1. So we have half into 5 into 10 and it is finally 25 meter. So displacement is equal to 25 meter. Moving ahead, let us consider velocity time graph of non-uniform velocity of an object. So observe figure 28 carefully here. In this figure, it represents velocity time graph of a non-uniform velocity of an object. This graph shows that the velocity of the object is increasing at a constant rate up to 2 seconds. Then the velocity is decreasing at a constant rate up to 4 seconds, again increasing up to 8 seconds, and then again decreasing up to 12 seconds. So finally we can say this is the graph of non-uniform velocity of an object. After discussing this all, we come at a conclusion that, note it. The very first one, speed is equal to slope of the distance time graph. Second, we have velocity is equal to slope of displacement time graph. Third one, we have distance traveled by a body is equal to area under speed time graph. Fourth, we have magnitude of displacement of a body is equal to area under velocity time graph. And the last we have, acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time taken, which we can get from slope of velocity time graph. This is end for the today. Thank you.